Little bit of bad news for Matt Gaetz. The ethics investigation that he's been facing for what feels like 25 years is heating up, apparently, according to the newest reports. And maybe more important than the fact that they are doing new investigations, they're talking to new witnesses, is what they're focusing on. And it is the allegation of child sex trafficking, which is not the only thing he's accused of doing, but it is perhaps the most dramatic and the most serious. So two different people familiar with the investigation apparently told the Daily Beast that the committee is now zeroing in on the sex trafficking allegations. A person briefed on the work added that investigators have contacted a number of women at the center of the child sex trafficking probe, including the former minor who is considered one of the victims in this case, and that they expect the outreach to be returned in the coming weeks. The source said they're specifically looking at sex trafficking as well as drugs and payments. Of course, the payments are, I think, inextricable from the trafficking allegations. But they've apparently reached out to multiple new witnesses, as well as witnesses that had been a part of the previous Department of Justice investigation. Remember, of course, that the DOJ declined to actually move forward on this, which I think for a lot of people was seen as a signal that either there's nothing there or they didn't believe that they could actually prove it. If the ethics committee is really heating up on this, then perhaps they've come up with something, a witness or a statement that the DOJ perhaps did not have access to, or alternatively, it could fizzle out as the DOJ's investigation did. Matt Gaetz seems sure that it will. He says these allegations are not true. They've never been true. The people who have made these allegations have been exposed, indicted, and in some cases imprisoned, which is largely true. Although bear in mind the fact that a guy who says he was a part of this plot with you going down for it doesn't necessarily disprove it. It maybe actually implies that this is more serious than you want to admit. But that said, as of right now, the representative has not been found guilty of this. These are still just allegations. So with all that said, David, what do you think of this?
If Democrats simply wanted to drag Matt Gaetz through the mud, this would be sort of a reasonable thing for them to do. However, they wouldn't be able to do it unless they also had some Republicans on the House Ethics Committee who also did not like Matt Gaetz. And that seems to be the case because the House Ethics Committee is divided. You can't just have one party decide, oh, we're going to pursue this and, you know, make hearings out of it and drag witnesses in and all that sort of thing. So it underscores that Matt Gaetz is not particularly well liked among Republicans. Democrats see the wise politics in all this, and that to the extent that they can hurt Matt Gaetz or get Republicans to have to defend child sex trafficking or whatever allegations Democrats want to make, whether it's fair or not, that also then starts to undercut Republicans who are arguing on sort of the social wars about, well, we have to ban books, we have to protect our children, we have to go after pedophiles. Every time the Democrats can say, hey, the Republicans are total hypocrites on this and they have a sex predator in their midst or whatever Democrats want to allege, whether it's fair or not, that's smart politics. And again, I don't think there's any way that a House Ethics Committee goes where a Justice Department would not go. But if you have people on that Ethics Committee who see a political advantage in highlighting this stuff, whether it goes in there or not, and having some hearings and having some witnesses come in, they're going to score political points. And that's a lot of what Congress does.
Yeah, that puts me in a weird position wherein, like a lot of people, I just want to know what actually happened. That's all. And the thing is, you lay out, there's so many different ways this could play out. It could be that he did it. It's hard to prove. So all we can do is score some political points. It could be we really don't know and they're going to score some political points. Or it could be that he's innocent. You know, it could be that he's totally innocent, but it's the whole area is kind of dirty. He was linked to some people that are really shady. And at the end of the day, he might be innocent of all of this. I don't think that I'm just in a bubble. I feel like the evidence that was presented early on is difficult to explain away that he didn't do any of this stuff. Sorry, it looks like you want to jump in.
Well, I was gonna say, even if he is innocent in a court of law, we're talking about the court of public opinion in terms of politics. And there is an advantage to Democrats and Republicans who don't like Matt Gaetz to portray him as immoral, as somebody who doesn't have core values or ethics. And so, yes, I mean, let's go ahead and have these hearings and let's, you know, by the way, I think there may be something orchestrated about all this because it's not just the House Ethics Committee, which is, you know, ramping this up, but there are now people who are trailing Matt Gaetz when he shows up in places like New Hampshire. And there was a guy who was trolling him the other day who pretended to be a reporter, then said, hey, Mr. Gaetz, how old was the schoolgirl that you were last with? And that gets picked up on social media. And again, it reminds everybody that he has this cloud, this scandal hanging over him. And to the extent that that scandal, that cloud hangs over him through November, that perhaps hurts other Republicans who are campaigning on, we're the party of family values. Oh yeah, really? What are you gonna do about Matt Gaetz? Well, no Republican wants to answer that question. It puts them in a pickle and it hurts them politically.
Yeah, I think your read of the politics of it is totally right. It's just that for me, like in theory, I could do that, could be my thing. You know, it looks bad for him. We don't know. I'm just gonna focus on it because it hurts him. But like fundamentally, I and I'm just speaking for myself, I really want to know what actually happened. And if he did not do this, if he didn't, you know, if he didn't do the trafficking, if he didn't, you know, basically like they throw around terms like child sex trafficking. We're talking about raping someone. That's what we're talking about. If he didn't do that, then I think it is fundamentally unfair for him to continue to be smeared about that, particularly when this is Matt Gaetz. There are all sorts of different things that you could attack him over. He's a really bad guy in a lot of ways. So I would rather choose something that's true. But that said, he's denied that it's done, but he has never provided what I think are compelling answers to the weird Venmo receipts about why this guy that he had been so close to for so long was saying that he had done all of this stuff. Like it just, you're not providing a compelling enough defense for me to not think that there might fundamentally be something there.
Yeah, maybe there is nothing more there because he's not coming clean. And look, I'll be the first to admit that I'm also sort of enjoying the salaciousness and the titillating sort of suggestions that are out there. I would love for somebody to come clean and say, here's exactly what happened, whether it's, you know, Matt Gaetz who comes clean or some investigative reporter. Matt Gaetz clearly wants to try to squelch this and not talk about it and bring any more attention. So he's going to lash out at anybody, House Ethics Committee, trolls, anybody else who brings it up. But yeah, there are some unanswered questions out there. And to the extent that those unanswered questions continue to sort of be in the zeitgeist, that hurts Matt Gaetz. And I think a lot of Democrats and some Republicans know it.
Yeah, and look, there are a lot of Republicans that are not fans of him and weren't before, let alone after this last year. They really do seem to despise him. There have been a lot of reports coming out about that. And the thing is, like, again, there are so many different reasons that you could not like him. You know, he's apparently a bad colleague. He causes a lot of drama. He also fundamentally doesn't really seem to care about being a congressman much of the time. He does a lot of media hits. But that said, he occasionally votes on the right side of something or, you know, sponsors legislation that other Republicans wouldn't. So it's just this really dirty mix. And at the end of the day, I just wanna know. I wanna know fundamentally what happened. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.